बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम योर साइंस टीचर फ्रॉम ग्रेड 5। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल कंटिन्यू यूनिट नंबर 7, दैट इज फोर्स एंड मशीन्स। एंड इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस पेज 63 एंड 64, एंड मेन टॉपिक ऑन दिस पेज इज इफेक्ट्स ऑफ फोर्स ऑन द मोशन ऑफ एन ऑब्जेक्ट। And we will see what are balance forces and what are unbalanced forces and what are their examples. So let's start from what is a force. Okay, force is a push or pull that causes an object to move, stop or change direction. Okay, so force is a push or pull. Look at this, that is push, this is pull. Okay, force is a push or pull. Because of pushing and pulling, what happened? Object move, stop, or they can change their direction. Okay, so what is a force? A force is a push or pull that causes an object to move, stop, or change direction. Clear? There are many different forces which act on objects, such as gravity and friction. Okay, look at this picture. Three forces acting here. First is the contact force. Okay, so contact force, because of contact force, the skater pushes against the ground. Second force is the force of gravity, and because of gravity, the skaters pull towards the ground. And third, the frictional force, that is between the wheel and the ground. Forces come in pairs. Okay, it means forces always occur in the form of pair. So they can be either balanced or unbalanced forces. Okay, look at this. This is unbalanced, this is balanced. This is just to show the difference between balanced and unbalanced. So forces, they occur in pair. They may be balanced forces or they may be unbalanced forces. If forces are balanced, the object does not move. Okay, it means if forces are balanced, then object does not move. And if forces are unbalanced, the object will do one of the following thing. It means they begins to move, stop moving, change direction, speed up, slow down. Okay, so first difference is that balanced forces, because of balanced forces, object is not able to move. And if forces are unbalanced, so objects begin to move, stop moving, change direction, speed up or slow down. Let's discuss the detail of balance forces. So balance forces do not cause change in motion. Look at this picture, that is the object and two persons are pushing this box. And so equal forces are applied from both sides, so forces are balanced, and because of balanced forces, this box is not able to move. Okay, so balanced forces do not cause change in motion, so this box will not be able to move because balanced forces are acting on that box from both sides. They are equal in size and opposite in direction. Okay, look at this. Equal forces, they are equal in size and opposite in direction. Okay, when forces are equal in size and opposite in direction, it means these are balanced forces. And the main thing is equal in size. Okay, if forces are equal in size, it means they are balanced. Now the truck stays still. Okay, look at this. Force pushing truck and force pushing truck from both sides. The force is applied on this truck is equal. Okay, from both side force is applied on that truck and equal force is applied on that truck. Because of that, the truck stay still. It means this truck will not move. Let's see few examples of balanced forces. First example. The ship is floating on the water. The forces are balanced. Which forces are acting on the ship? Okay, this is the question. The ship is floating on water. the forces are balanced, which forces are acting on the shape. Okay, so because of gravity force, okay, look at this gravity, that is downward force, and the water force, that is in upward direction, they are equal. That's why ship stay floating. Okay, ship, the balance force is applied on the ship and that's why it float. Okay, look at this picture. Gravity in downward direction and water forces in upward direction, and because of that forces are balanced. Now let's see the second example. The vase is resting on the table. It is not moving, therefore the forces must be balanced. Which forces are acting on the vase? Look at this diagram. Two forces are there. First is the gravity that pull it is in downward direction, and second one is the table up thrust. Its direction is upward direction. So both forces are balanced. Because of that, this vase is resting on the table. So if we observe our surrounding, a lot of objects are present in our home and everywhere which have balanced forces. Now, second type of forces are unbalanced forces. Okay, unbalanced forces cause a change in motion by changing the object's speed or direction. Okay, unbalanced forces cause a change in motion by changing the object's speed or direction. Now look at this, truck speed up in this direction. Look at the reason. On that side, the bigger force is applied on it, that is 100 Newton. And in opposite direction, we have other force that is smaller, it is 60 Newton. So because of this bigger force, this truck is moving in that direction. Okay, so forces are unbalanced. On one side it is 100 Newton and on other side it is 60 Newton. Okay, so because of unbalanced forces, speed or direction of the objects are changing. When two forces are acting on an object are not equal in size, we say forces are unbalanced. Okay, if in when two forces acting on object, but these forces are not equal, then that forces are called as unbalanced forces. Now let's see a few example of unbalanced forces. First, the man and parachute are slowly falling to the ground. Which forces are acting on parachute? Which force is bigger and how can you tell? Okay, so gravity is the bigger force. We can tell this because the direction of movement of man and the parachute is same as the direction of force of gravity. Okay, look at this. Gravity is the pulling, gravity pulling the man to the ground, and second force acting here is the air resistance that is pushing upward direction, but the man and parachute is moving in downward direction. This shows that the force of gravity is bigger in that case. Okay, now second example, the same forces are acting on the elephant but without a parachute. There is much less air resistance. Okay, so gravity is a much bigger force because there is bigger difference between the force pulling downwards and the force pushing upward. The elephant falls much more quickly than a man with a parachute. Okay, so again here air resistance is pushing upward direction, but in here in that case gravity is the gravity is much bigger than the air resistance. So the elephant, they are moving towards the ground with more speed. Now see one more example. In a tug of war, each side exert a force on the rope. If opposing force are equal, then they are balanced and the rope does not move. Okay, look at here. On both sides, equal forces applied. So forces are balanced and rope does not move. Now in second case, if one force is greater than the other, the forces are unbalanced and the rope move in the direction of greater force. Look at these arrows, this shows the forces. Okay, so it's mean on that side lesser force is applied, on that side higher or more force or greater force are applied. So in case of unbalanced forces, the rope move in the direction of greater forces, okay? So in this game, in this tug of war, we have both type of condition, balanced forces and unbalanced forces. If equal forces are applied, mean balanced, and if unequal forces are applied, it mean that are unbalanced. Now let's see, in that case, arm wrestling, that is the balanced because equal forces are there. And in this picture, these are unbalanced because from that side, that is the bigger force, and other side, this is the smaller force. So they are unbalanced, and here in that case, that is the balanced forces. Now in balanced forces, the net force is zero, so no movement. And unbalanced forces, so net forces is not zero, that's why object move. Now resultant forces, the sum of effect of more than one force is called resultant force. You can find out the resultant force by calculating the difference between the opposing force, okay? So like this, on this side there is 500 newton and here 400 newton. So 500 minus 400 newton, so we have resultant force, that is 100 newton. So two important things to remember when working with balanced and unbalanced forces are, first one, forces in same direction combined by addition. It means if forces are applied from same direction, we add the forces, okay? And forces in opposite direction combined by subtraction, okay? So we add forces by subtraction. Okay, let's see some more examples of balanced and unbalanced forces, okay? An aeroplane taking off, so here forces are unbalanced. A book resting on a table, so forces are balanced. Kicking a football, so forces are unbalanced. A picture hanging on a wall, balanced forces. A parachutist falling at constant speed, balanced forces. Stretching a string, unbalanced forces. A car slowing down, unbalanced forces. A bike speeding up, unbalanced forces. And a boy standing still, at that time forces are balanced. Hope you will understand the difference between balanced and unbalanced forces, and you can easily distinguish between the examples of balanced and unbalanced forces. Okay, thank you. Take care.